Proverbs chapter 3, verse 1 says, "My son, do not forget my law, but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and long life and peace they will add to you. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them around your neck.
Yes.
Write them on the tablet of your heart.
Thank you.
And so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man." Now, if that wasn't good enough for you, let's keep on reading. "Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Thank you, Lord.
And lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil.
Yes.
It will be health in your flesh and strength in your bones. It will be health in your flesh." Come on, touch yourself. That means you. That means me. I got flesh on these bones. "It will be health in your flesh and what? Strength to your bones." Anybody need strength to their bones? I do. The next verse says, "Honor the Lord with what? And with the first fruits of all your increase. So your barns will be filled with what?
Plenty."
Y'all get this?
Amen.
"And your vats will overflow with new wine." Can you give God praise for the reading of this word? So thank you, young people, for announcing my text today. Trust in the Lord. Now, congregation, can you repeat it?
Trust in the Lord.
Again.
Trust in the Lord.
Again.
Trust in the Lord.
Well, okay, I get it. Okay. So I want to, just for a few minutes, you can be seated in the house of the Lord. That trust element, that total reliance on Jesus Christ, total reliance. Now, all of you exercise trust and faith when you walked into the building.
That's right.
And what I mean by that, Mother Cook, Brother Doug, is that I saw you all come in, even I did. I came in, I sat down. I didn't look under the bench to see all the screws were there. I just trusted.
That's right.
I didn't see Jada look under the pew to see, be sure it wasn't gonna fall down. She trusted that pew and to hold her up. All of us did. I didn't see nobody come in and say, before you sit down, checking out the series like that. So what caused that? History.
That's right.
You've been here before. Or you know what it looks like, a pew, a chair.
That's right.
So this is the house of the Lord. You just have confidence. These pews don't hold me up. Trust.
Amen.
So trust is earned.
Thank you.
It's not given. Trust is earned.
Amen.
So trust in the Lord. So why Jada, why Hezekiah and Diamond? Why were you saying to me, Bobby, to trust in the Lord? I know the saints here have a good idea what I mean, but to Jacob, what does it mean to trust in the Lord? Well, let's define who the Lord is. The Lord Jesus Christ. That's who I'm talking about. God raised him from the dead.
Amen.
On the third day according to the scriptures.
Yeah.
So Jacob, you know anybody that's been raised from the dead?
Just
Jesus. Thank you. Well, she is quick.
Yeah.
She didn't hesitate. And hey, listen, you're on your way to a great life when you acknowledge that God raised Jesus from the dead. Now trust him. Trust the Lord. This is his word.
That's right.
So every minute you can, read this word. God is his word. The word is God. Trust in the Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, can we give God one more praise? I'm trying to cut this down so I can get out of here for God. Trust in the Lord. Anybody in here trusting in the Lord right now? Just give God praise. If you know you trust him, in the Lord, give him praise and glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Trust. Thank you, Jesus.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Yes.
Verse 5 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Well, let me just tell you what I had experiences for my own self. That at times I trust in the Lord and then I go try to fix it. All right. That ain't gonna work, y'all.
That's right.
I found out if you're gonna trust the Lord, give it to him. Take your hands off of it. Give him praise for the answer. Hallelujah. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Hallelujah. Trust is earned. I never will forget the first time Maria invited me for dinner.
Yes.
I know Pastor Wilson's cooking. I know my mom's cooking.
That's right.
I know Mother Jones is cooking. History.
Uh-huh.
We go way back. The dinners we used to cook in the basement. By the way, we plan to get that kitchen back up and running very soon.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Yes. But so I didn't know what to expect with Maria's cooking. Mother White, Mother White, Brother Cook, Maria can throw down. Woo! Thank God for my wife. Thank you, Jesus. Not too long ago, I didn't know what was gonna be for dinner. I kept smelling something. All she had was the best beans and cornbread you ever had in your life. No meat. She had them beans seasoned like, whoa! And the cornbread homemade. Okay, back to this. So she's earned my trust in her cooking skills.
And that's right.
She even had my clothes laid out for me when I got back home this morning. I thank God for that, y'all. I want to thank God in public for my wife. All you do.
Oh, yes.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. That's where that history element comes up in. Because we all have history. You went to school.
Yes.
You've met people.
Yes.
You've had different experiences. You know, and it's nothing like, you know, there's two people you will always remember.
Yes.
The ones who are nice to you.
Yes.
And the ones who are not.
Amen.
Bottom line, I can tell you people from school days, that wasn't nice to me. If I see that joker now, he didn't have it. The reason I say that is because when I went to Booker T. Junior Washington High School, seventh grade, eighth grade, something. Y'all remember the Apple hat? The big pancake hat we used to wear back in the day. You know, I had, and I would have one, and after school, he'd run by me and snatch my hat. And look back at me and laugh. And I told my grandfather about it. And he let me know that ain't gonna happen no more. He told me, as far as fighting, he said, Bobby, if I hear anybody beating you, I'm gonna beat you. That's all I need to hear. Come on with it. I had this string from my ceiling with a little ball on it in the basement, and I would practice my karate kicks. Cause I was gonna be prepared. And I would shadow box with nobody in front of me, but I could see them. And I practiced my karate kicks. Oh yeah. I know that's leading to my own understanding, but my grandfather told me. So listen, as I shorten this message, the Lord, come on, say the Lord.
The Lord.
The Lord who's strong and mighty. The Lord Ancient of Days. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was what? That's why we should trust in the Lord. He's already been there. He knows everything. God is everywhere. He knows everything, and He can do anything. Will you give Him praise? He is the Almighty God. That's why we trust in the Lord and lean not to our own understanding. We have 66 books.
That's right. That's
66 true. Books.
Yes. Amen.
To trust in the Lord. From Genesis to Revelation.
That's right.
Ain't no excuse, Diamond.
Amen.
Hezekiah, ain't no excuse. Jada, no excuse. Hallelujah.
I started reading. That's when the first thing I read was a Bible. And I dabbled in with the Bible.
I don't know why y'all not standing on y'all. Did you hear this young person say that?
That's right.
Because Pastor Wilson said you're young if you're under 45. So it's under 45. Even if you 45 and 99 days, you still before you turn 46. I am so glad you have inspired me. When you jumped and said, trust in the Lord, I said, Lord, thank you, God. Thank you, God. We need you, Jada. Roanoke needs you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. All power has been given unto him in heavens and where? In the earth and beneath the earth. And God have highly exalted him and given him a name that's above every name. That at the name of Jesus Christ, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. That's why we should trust in the Lord. His name is above every name.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay, you said, well, Bobby, you just talking. No. Read Genesis to Revelation. Genesis to Revelation. Come on, stand to your feet. As Pastor Wilson said, I got a whole lot more. But I'm going to obey God.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm counting. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There's 15 people in here. God uses people. God uses you. I'm telling you now. He will use you to bring salvation to somebody in this city, in your neighborhood.
Yes, he do.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
I want to encourage everybody to, as CeCe Winans was singing, believe God. That's why I want to take that moment. Just to believe God. Will you get somebody on your mind? Will you get some need? Maybe somebody else. Get that need on your mind. Lord, we believe you.
Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus.
Yekoshan, I believe you, Lord, and we believe you. In the name of Jesus. I'm just going to call out some names. Reggie Davis, Terry White,
yes.
Pastor Jay White,
yes.
Hallelujah. Daryl White,
yes.
Michael Allen,
yes.
Earl Glover, Rufus Glover,
yes.
Tyrone Flint.
Jesus.
Lord, we believe.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We believe this morning for deliverance.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Jesus,
Lord.
We believe you, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I believe you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Pastor Wilson feeling
yes,
better
yes,
as you go out the door in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
miracles, signs, and wonders.
Yes,
miracles, signs, and wonders.
Yes.
Miracles, signs, and
yes,
wonders.
Yes.
Miracles, signs, and wonders, Lord, that your name will be glorified.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, God.
Lord.
We trust
thank
in
Jesus.
You, Lord.
Yes.
You're Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You're Lord over the earth. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof and all they that dwell therein.
Lord.
Hallelujah. Is there anything too hard for God?
Yes, no,
is there anything too hard for God? Is there anything too hard for God?
Nothing.
Thank you, Lord, for visiting us today.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for visiting us on yesterday, on Friday, on Thursday of last week. And we thank you, Lord, you're going to visit with us this coming week. Thank you in advance. You said you would never leave us. Never leave us nor forsake
thank
us.
You, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Lord, thank you.
Thank you.
You told
Lord.
Me to call the name Sister Wanda Lee. Hallelujah.
Yes.
God knows your heart.
Yes.
He knows your need.
That's right.
He knows your family need.
You,
he knows everything you need. We touch and agree with Sister Wanda Lee that those things she believed me for shall come to pass. Come on, give God praise. It shall come to pass.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, we got to touch and agree right quick. Just if you can grab somebody's neighbor.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Somebody.
Thank you.
We give you praise. We give you the praise, God. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
According to